Welcome to the Festival Hall for the first of three concerts given by Émile Gilbert to celebrate the 131st anniversary of the birth of Tchaikovsky. Gilbert starts tonight with Tchaikovsky's Contessa Padovana. Oh dear, Gilbert has trodden on his violin. He's put his foot through the bridge and sat on the soundpost. Is he going to attempt to finish the piece? I think he is. He's picked up the sound case and fingerboard of this beautiful 17th century instrument, actually made by Nicola Amati at Cremona, and he's trying to wedge them under his chin. But no, it's no good. The applause you can hear now is because the leader of the orchestra is going over to Gilbert to lend him his own violin. By no means less instrument than Gilbert's. It is in fact a Stradivarius, so this is a very sporting gesture. And now Gilbert prepares once again to play Tchaikovsky's Contessa Padovana. Oh dear, the end's come off. He's caught the peg box in one of the uprights of his music stand, and in trying to get it out with his ear, he's completely snapped off the fingerboard. What a pity. I've certainly never seen this happen before in the festival hall, and the leader of the orchestra's not looking very pleased. In fact, he's punched Gilbert in the face. There's a bit of blood, but Gilbert has managed to snatch another instrument from the second violins, and he's climbing off the way up towards the organ, and he's going to have yet another bash at Tchaikovsky's Contessa Padovana. And he's crushed the soundbox with his chin on the second bar there. This really isn't his day. And now the conductor, Otto Klemperer, is hopping across the stage towards Gilbert and trying to poke at him with a stick. I must say this is amazing. It's the first time in the festival hall that I've seen a violinist of Gilbert's caliber poked with a stick. And one of the oboists has leapt onto Klemperer's back and is pulling his hair out. I must say it's wonderful to see the loyalty which a great soloist like Gilbert can still command amongst his fellow musicians. In fact, several of the cellists have thrown off their clothes and are making a vast human pyramid, standing a full 30 feet above the smoke and flames drifting across from the blazing wind section. And through the smoke I can see, yes, I can see the timpanist, one of Britain's best, has lashed himself and a Japanese friend to the kettle drum and is rolling off the stage towards the pit of ordure that has opened up under the first six rows of the stalls. Whilst throughout this, the rather unpleasant business of prizing Gilbert out from between the organ pipes is being undertaken by men of the Royal Engineers. And Gilbert is half out. He's got an army violin, and he's having another go at the Contessa Padovana, and he's playing beautifully. Oh, dear! One of the Royal Engineers has stuck a crowbar through his chest, and he's dropped the violin. And these very fit young leopards have pounced upon it and are already taking bits of it across to Herr Willy Brandt on the other side of the stage. While the police have erected barriers now to keep people away from the rubble, and as fighters swoop down to bomb the last part of resistance, we go on to the next part of our programme. The Sonatina in E-sharp by Antonio Vivaldi, played by a Pablo Casals during his 400-foot plunge into a bucket of boiling fat.